Hey guys, so I saw this on the workshop and I was like, wow, that's pretty crazy looking. So this is the Great Guardian Hanuman by Benok. And let's do a quick fly around here. It's kind of laggy, I'm guessing that's because of all the sub-grids on the ship. Alright, so the ship is 21,184 PCO. Let me lower my volume. So, you know, this is slightly over PCO. But it's not that much over PCO, so you can probably delete some things to make this below 20,000 PCO if you want. Alright, so the biggest thing that sticks out of this build is, well, just how insane the whole ship looks. We have some diagonal panels. Look at this bridge. I don't think this is like a bridge, it's more like the design on top of the ship. I'm not sure what to call it. It's asymmetrical and stuff. Alright, so in terms of weapons, we have some, are these assault cannons? Oh, these are even worse than assault cannons. These are auto cannons on subgrids, which, you know, it looks pretty cool, but it has like a very awful range and damage. So in terms of damaging anything, well, but you know, that's fine. Aesthetically speaking, that's super cool. To the side we have, where's the other weapons? At least the ship has railguns, which are actually useful against other big ships. We have an interior turret and more of these auto cannons up here. More interior turrets. Look at how this ship looks, guys. I really like how this ship looks. It's crazy. Oh, it looks like my room. Alright, are those the whole weapons? Are there no weapons down here? Where's the other weapons? Oh, there's an interior turret down here. Very creative placement, but you know, this grating is kind of weak, so that might be a problem, but you know, it's fine. So in terms of weapons, well, oh, my game is freezing. You have some very useful railguns and useful interior turrets against jetpackers with decorative autocannons. I mean, again, they look very cool, but you know, they might as well be decorations. Alright, let's continue to the front. We have, oof, this must have a very good backward thruster. I mean, backward thrust amount. We have some exposed hydrogen tanks, which helps in reducing the weight of the ship, but you know, that exposed the hydrogen tanks, which might explode. Judging from the placement of the hydrogen tanks, if they do explode, I mean, you won't be losing that much. They are placed on nacelles, and there's not like very important components on these nacelles. I mean, I guess there are thrusters. So if these exposed hydrogen tanks explode, you will lose a lot of stuff, but it won't disable the ship, I think. And down here, we have some magnetic plates for the landing gears on suspensions. I mean, that's fine, other than the fact that this suspension costs 50 PCO. Where does this... Look at how they use this conveyor pipe cap, wow. This makes the ship looks very industrial, right? Very cool. Alright, let's try to walk around here. I guess this is somewhat walkable, so can we access this place from the ground? So there's this ladder, so we can access this whole platform from the ground, so that's nice. That makes this section walkable even if you don't have jetpack fuel. Oh wow, look at how they use these panels. Do you guys see how they use these different panels to make some kind of an opening? I mean, to make different kinds of openings. That's very creative. To the back here, we have more landing gears. If you just want to use these landing gears for landing, this is a little bit excessive. You only need one of these. But the advantage of having multiple magnetic plates or landing gears like this is that you can use these things to tow many different things. So for example, if you want to tow some ships and then you want to tow for more things like smaller ships or some objects, then you can do that with multiple landing gears or magnetic plates. We have an access panel here and some thrusters. Oh, what the hell? Wait, what? Why do we have a block connector? I mean, I'm guessing this can still work. Like, it can probably still connect with other connectors. This is like a very bad placement for a connector though. It's like half recessed and there's like magnetic plates around it and it's very close to thrusters. So practically speaking, this is not a good place for a connector. People are weird. I do see a large amount of upper thrusters, so that's a good sign. We have more spotlights here, I mean a spotlight there. And to the back here, oh, that's a lot of thrusters. Alright, let's talk about the diagonal aesthetic design element. This is certainly a nice design or aesthetic touch to the ship, and it's kind of crazy how well they align the angled element with the rest of the ship properly. But you know, the thing about things like this is that they use subgrids. Do these actually use subgrids though? Yeah, there you go. Do you see the hinge there? They use a hinge. So something like this will make the ship unstable in gravity. Not to mention, if that hinge got shot or malfunction or glitch out for some reason, which happens a lot on space engineers, you're most likely to damage or lose the whole ship from that glitching out. So you know, these are pretty cool, but those are things to consider when you play with things like this. To the front of the ship, we have more walkable area. Well, it is walkable. And more of these openings here, very cool. Oh wait, is this whole thing subgrids? What the hell? Huh, this whole thing on the top here is on a subgrid. I don't think they can rotate though. Can they rotate? Well, I guess we'll find out soon. Alright, I guess that's the whole exterior. Let's get inside now. There's a bottom entrance. I was gonna enter from the side entrance, but you know, if you're on the ground or something, you'll probably enter the ship from down here. So we're gonna enter the ship from down here. Alright. Ooh. Very nice aesthetic vibe here. Alright, let's get inside. This is a simple depressurizable airlock with the air fender and an armory. Very cool. Let me turn off my headlight. Warning, no atmosphere beyond this point. Well, that's a lie. There's an atmosphere there. Alright, let's go up here. Oh, look at the vibe of this place. Wow, are you guys seeing this? This doesn't even feel like Space Engineers. It feels like I'm playing Dead Space or something. Pretty cool, right? Oh, wow. Look at this interior. The creator definitely knows what they are doing in terms of design and aesthetic. Infirmary. I feel like I'm just gonna keep saying the same thing over and over again. It's pretty cool. Do you guys see what they did here? With the what the hell? They use small grid subgrid just to have this spotlight thingy over here. And we have frozen cryopods with what the hell? Is that a magnetic plate? What? Oh, this is a suspension. Yeah, that's kind of what I thought as well. Well, I guess I don't have to say anything about this room. You guys can see that it's pretty well designed and cool. Oh, there's a bed here. Alright, to the back here, we have a very private toilet. Ah, I prefer bedroom than a toilet because it has more privacy and a shower. There's also a screen next to the bed, so I can probably put some graphics there. Maybe it's supposed to be a TV for the bed or something. Well, I guess if your friend is like sleeping there, and you want to tell them something when they get back online, you can put something on the LCD screen. Alright. We have an event controller, programmable block. That's a hard word to say, by the way. Programmable block. Alright. I saw this, by the way. This jump drive is exposed from this corridor, right? That means this jump drive is repairable from the inside. So that's a nice thing to have, to be able to repair your jump drive from the inside like that. What's this room here? Huh. Oh wow. I'm guessing this is the Combat Information Center. This is the gravity generator. I mean, look at this room, guys. Wow. If you guys play Space Engineers for the atmosphere, you should totally download the ship. It's crazy. Armory. There's a TV screen there. I'm guessing that's part of the programmable blocks. This is some kind of a crew quarter. Look at how they did the kitchen. Are you guys seeing this? Very creative again. I'm kind of at loss of words here. I think this is genuinely the ship with the best interior that I've reviewed or even seen on Space Engineers so far. The attention to details and the sense of aesthetic in general is just very high. I mean, look at this room of I'll just stop talking about it at this point. I'm guessing that's some kind of a side room thingy. Alright. And over here. It's very big in here. I wasn't expecting the interior of the ship to be this intricate. We have a cargo access here. I'm guessing this is some kind of a bedroom. And to the top here. Some kind of a lounge with some beds. Look at the roofing. I mean the ceiling. Oh wow. Alright, let's go back up there now. We have more of those opening panels. Crazy. I feel like Kin should be including the ship in there. This is the power generator room, I'm guessing. We have some hydrogen engines. Pretty cool. They seem to be using so many air vents though. That's what happens when you have too many doors on your ship. If you want to save some PCO, you can just remove these doors and you won't have as many doors and you also won't have as many air vents. Alright, is that the whole interior? No, that's not the whole interior. Because there was like that side entrance, do you guys remember? I'm guessing it's this place over here. Yeah, this is the side entrance that we saw earlier. It's a pretty simple side entrance, so that's nice. It's like a very simple airlock, you know. Alright, that's the whole interior, which is pretty great. And here's the survival kit, by the way. I saw this earlier. Alright, let's check the internals now. The ship has 6 large hydrogen tanks, and the ship weighs 1.7 kilotons. Yeah, that's a decent amount of fuel. There's a lot of batteries, so that's nice. Oh, there's no reactor. Interesting. So I'm guessing the only power generation blocks on the ship are the hydrogen engines. Do we have solar panels? We do have solar panels, so that's nice. I mean, they're incomplete, so you probably want to weld them up. But at least we do have solar panels on the ship. That's a lot of gyroscopes. I don't think you need that many gyroscopes on the ship. Oh, only 4 H2 generator stuff. So if we do end up trimming down the PCO on the ship, you probably want to use those extra PCO for more H2 generators so you don't take hours to refuel. We don't have a refinery, but we do have an assembler. So the only way the ship can refine materials is from the survival kit, which is very limited. So you know, you probably want to add at least a basic refinery on the ship, or a full-size refinery, because that's gonna make the ship a lot more useful in survival. Do we have a safe zone? No safe zone. No store block, no contracts block. There's quite a lot of custom turret controllers. I'm guessing those are for the custom turrets out there. We have 2 oxygen tanks, which is reasonable. And we have a single jump drive, which is also reasonable. Alright, I guess that's the whole internals. Let's fly the ship now. Forward acceleration is pretty decent. You can accelerate really quickly with the ship. Look at how the ship looks, by the way. Isn't it crazy? Upward acceleration is decent. I mean, it's not as good as the forward acceleration, but you know, downward acceleration is also decent. Backward acceleration is, well, same thing, it's decent. Strafing acceleration is also decent. So, you know, acceptable acceleration. In terms of turning speed though, and I know this because I kind of tried to turn earlier, it's pretty heavy to turn considering how many gyroscopes the ship have. That's most likely because of the subgrids. So that's one more reason why you probably don't want to use subgrids on your ship if you don't really have to. Alright, let's fly the ship on the planet now. We have 24 small upward thrusters and the ship weighs 1.7 kilotons. So they should be able to fly on the planet just fine. And teleporting now. There you go, we're flying on the planet just fine. So yeah, that interior is pretty crazy. I guess it's safe to say that this is the ship that probably has the best kind of interior in terms of quality, or at least one of the best on Space Engineers. In terms of survival, this should be, well, reasonably practical to use in survival. You probably want to add a refinery and, you know, add some more H2 generators and probably remove some of the excess things that's bloating the PCO. But those are modifications that should be easy to do if you download the ship. The weapons, well, if you're not fighting other players, then this is fine. But if you're fighting other players, then well, at least you have railguns, which can be very useful. But those autocannons on the subgrids probably won't help that much. But we do have lots of interior turrets, so this probably do decently well against jetpackers. totally not a good combat ship though in terms of PCU to combat performance ratio. The ship can certainly use some optimizations in PCU as well as, you know, like you have so many doors that you don't really need and stuff like that. But if you really need the PCU, it should be fairly easy to optimize the ship when you download it. Oh, I forgot to mention there's also an antenna there. Well, some antennas. The subgrids will totally be a problem in survival, not only in the operation of the ship, but also in terms of how you can build or weld the ship. It's gonna be a lot harder to weld things that are on subgrids like this. It's just a lot trickier in general. Let's try those custom turrets though. Where's the control? Oh, there you go. I'm guessing this is the main custom turret on the top that's like a big turret. Let's shoot the railguns. Pretty cool. This will certainly be fun to use in multiplayer survival, at least if you're not fighting other players. But you know, if you're just fighting NPC with your friends, this can be really fun because your friends can control this railgun turret and there's like a lot of them. But I totally won't recommend using this ship in like a serious PvP multiplayer kind of playthrough. Well, unless you really like the look of the ship. But yeah, overall, it's a reasonably practical ship that can made to be even more practical. It's kind of high on PCU, but you can easily reduce the PCU by removing the excess stuff and stuff. I'm very smart with words. Totally not the best combat ship, but it can certainly be fun to use with friends. Alright, let's craft the ship now. I'm guessing this will be fairly spectacular, considering all the subgrids on the ship. Alright, I'm gonna crest on that hill over there. Oh, here goes. I can already feel the lag coming. Oh wow. Yeah, that's pretty spectacular. Oh, there goes the combat information center. Are we gonna lose the whole ship? Very nice. Rip the performance though. I'm guessing it's all the subgrids making my FPS really low. Very nice. Is there anything left of the combat information center? Well, I guess there's still one seat left over there. The big turret survived though. I mean, never mind. It got ripped. Say, that's the Great Guardian Hanuman by Benok. You guys can find the link in the description below.